Go ahead and drive. There's something I need to play for you. You want to hear Marcano tear Uncle Lou a new one?
Lou Marcano was bribing a district judge named Cornelius Holden, is that correct?
Sal Marcano spent a lot of money getting Holden in his pocket. A lot of money. Judges like that don't come cheap. And with Holden out of the picture, Sal had to find someone else to legalize gambling.
And that person was State Senator Walter Jacobs.
That's right.
You had one fucking job, Lou. Now it's to keep holding him one goddamn pistol after that room.
What was I supposed to do? He wouldn't listen, Sal. It ain't my fault.
Nothing's ever your goddamn fault. I swear, if you wasn't my brother, I'd clip you myself.
Now listen here. I know a guy, a state senator named Jacobs. He's on the Revenue and Fiscal Affairs Committee. Has a lot of influence.
Can we get to him?
Already have. He has a thing for fucking on women who ain't his wife.
I don't want to twist this guy's balls out of the gate, you understand? We need to be smart about this.
Yeah, of course. How about I throw him a fundraiser on the riverboat? Show him a real nice time. Get him laid, all that shit.
This goddamn casino got me tapped, you understand? This goes down to shit or we're fucked, all of us.
Well, I'll pick the guests myself. Make sure they know what's what. Then we'll take a nice long cruise down the bayou, get them all liquored up. Once he sees that payday, Jacobs is gonna do whatever we want.
Lou Marcano knew everyone. I mean, politicians, merchants, lawyers, bankers. He insisted on being called Uncle Lou, and was basically the Santa Claus of the French ward.
According to the police reports, Mr. Marcano and Mr. Jacobs were killed during a fundraiser on a riverboat.
Thing about the bayou is it's a very big place. You could blow the living shit out of everything in sight and no one would even notice.
Ready to go when you are.
Assume you already mapped out where the riverboat's gonna go.
Lou's pretty fastidious about that kind of thing. Always follows the same path when he goes cruising through the bayou. Doesn't want anything to happen to his beloved Delphine.
Gonna be the least of his problems. You recon the area?
There's an old coal dumper that they have to sail past. I've already got it rigged to blow. You just need to connect the primer cord to each block and then set it off. Detonator's down by your feet.
All right.
Isolate and kill. Lincoln Clay's specialty. What's wrong? It's the boat thing, isn't it?
Not saying it is, not saying it ain't.
You need to get over it. You were on what, 40, 45 PBRs in country?
52. That's not the point. You don't know what it's like to get onto a boat knowing full well the damn thing's gonna sink? Gets old, man.
Look, you blow the coal dumper, boom, it hits the boat. Then you jump on board and kill Lou and those other assholes. 50-50, you don't even get wet.
50-50?
40-60, but still. .30-70 at the worst.
Right there.
ain't none for you to worry about. Let's get you upstairs. You all fan out. Watch the rest of the boat. This sure shit wasn't an accident.
Thank you.
this your day to die?
Look who I found. Grabbing some cover.
Fuck! Reload.
Fire, pin him down.
Red flag. Get
in line behind me.
Ooh, waiting all day for this. Here's our chance.
These people off!
Find that motherfucker so we can get off this!
Buddy, we gotta move.
Motherfucker. Boy, I ain't going nowhere.
Damn. That shit's all him.
That's far enough, you wop asshole!
What the fuck, Lou?
Take another step and he gets it. You think I give a shit about some politician?
Please,
place. I don't even know what's going on.
I got money. You can have it. All of it. Just don't kill me.
I don't want your money. I want you to send a message to your brother.
Yeah. Anything. Oh, just say it. Just say it.
Lord Almighty.
Explosion aboard a riverboat. Local businessman Louis Marcano also lost his life, along with dozens of other wealthy donors there to attend a political fundraiser.
When Lincoln left his gutted body on a statue commemorating Andrew Jackson, people were horrified. I mean, how could that be anything but a political statement?
Lincoln once told me he couldn't tell any other cheek. That the world doesn't work that way. I spent the better part of 40 years trying to prove him wrong. But I was just lying to myself. Look at how we treat each other. Compassion is a sign of weakness. But greed is a virtue. The poor is considered morally corrupt while every excess of the powerful is celebrated. We sent kids off to die. For what? So someone can make a few bucks? Lincoln was right. He was always right. There ain't never gonna be another Dr. King or Bobby Kennedy. But there's always gonna be another Sal Marcano, another Sammy Robinson, another Lincoln Clay. We are cruel and wicked people.
All hail the motherfucking king! Nice work out there. The entire goddamn city's buzzing about what we done to Meccano.
There's no one left to stand in our way. We run this city now.
Listen, I've been doing my best to be patient over the last couple of times we sat at this table, watching others get what I want. But now? Now I got my taste of both rackets here. And the money we can make can help a lot of folks back in the holler. This turf needs to stay with me.
Last time we sat at this table, you called on me. Why? Because you know I'm the motherfucker who gets shit done. Always will be.
I'm glad to hear we got Marcano's cocksuckers on the run, and I'm willing to look past the fact that you didn't call me about this action, if you just give me the turf altogether.
It's been a long road, Lincoln. Finish this right.
I stuck around this long when I could have turned you over to Marcano with one phone.
Take your time, lad. Wouldn't want to fuck up it.
You got no idea how...
Don't second guess this, Lincoln.
The Haitians will run this part of the city.
We got a lot to work with here, brother. This is real good. I halfway figured Lincoln will have killed us all by now. What we done here? Taking the city away from Marcana and doing it without killing each other? We gotta be proud of that. Not everything went the way I would have liked it to go, but I'm proud of what I have and what we starting here.
Kinda thought I'd be gay to shit by now. So anything shy of that, and I'm good. Fuck. Fuck. You know how long I've been waiting for someone to stand up and be a man of his word? And in all my fucking days, you, Lincoln Clay, are the first motherfucker to do it. Thank you. You've done a hell of a job, Lincoln. Couldn't have done a better job myself. Probably.
Holy Christ! How the fuck did we make it through this shite in one piece? I thought for certain Scaletta'd have his throat slit by now. You did a bang-up job here, lad. A goddamn dream come true. Can't wait to see where we go from here.
We're living proof that the ways of Marcano, the lying, the backstabbing, the cheating, don't need to run in that direction. Those ways are as dead as he is. You're not wasting any time, are you?
Your little rampage is going to attract attention. Attention from people I don't care to associate with.
Yeah, imagine not.
Thankfully, closing off your loose ends is as simple as tossing around some super grade. With any luck, this will keep them off my ass. For a little while, anyway. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. There's still the matter of killing Georgie and Sal. You should get a kick out of hearing this.
Goddamn motherfucking piece of shit! Loose dead. They found him tied to that statue of Jackson over in the French ward. He was gutted like a goddamn catfish.
Jesus fucking Christ.
This was that goddamn nigga Lincoln Clay. We would not be in this fucking mess if you'd done what you were supposed to do.
You in here? I shot him right in the fucking head.
Once! You shot him once! I am leveraged out the ass. Called in every favor. And none of it made a goddamn difference. We're fucked. I am fucked.
Oh, now that's bullshit. We still got some men. I say we hit the streets and we found that cocksucker.
Every low-life ball of piss in this city spills blood in the water. My blood, do you understand? And they'd step over their own mother if it meant being the one that clipped me I wouldn't last 10 fucking minutes out there.
That's a crock of shit. You forget? You are Sal Marcano. Well, there's got to be something we can do.
Call whatever men we still have left. You're telling me just up there at the casino. When Lincoln Flynn shows up, we're gonna do everything we can to plant that goddamn nigga in the ground. Right next to us. That's what we can do. Go on, get the fuck out of here. Go!
Should have known that Marcano would go to ground at the casino.
You can take the bridge up there so it's a straight shot.
You know, none of this would have happened without you.
It's either this or right away in some goddamn office. And once you've killed those assholes, you come and find me. I'll be hanging around over at the Padres.
You got it.
You give them hell, champ.
Big mistake, asshole. Run up a cover. That had to fucking hurt.
Down. Those fucking bones!
You want
another man? Fucking legs off! Think fast! For cover! Mystery fucking solved! Get the asshole! I gotta lead the way. I'm in the world of...
Run for cover. Enjoy this, boy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah, I thought it was gonna be a quiet one.
Cover my ass!
Downstairs handle this. It's what they're getting paid for. I ain't come here to watch someone else do all the work. I came here to bury that cocksucker, just like we said. Be careful, yeah? I ain't the one.
You, Georgie, it's over.
What you think I'm gonna roll over like a fucking dog? Fuck you,
cocksucker!
Shouldn't have come here.
Yeah, I'm pinned in. Need to reload.
Yeah, piece of shit.
Found him! I got this!
There you are!
Dead asshole! 12 o'clock!
His ass!
Grenade in!
Throwing grenade!
That shit's all him. Let's go!
Get out of here!
There!
Shit down!
Stay out of my way!
Oh, boy!
You cover me while I reload!
Master got me trapped,
son of a bitch!
Fast, bitch!
Can't fucking move!
Boys.
I've been a while to hide here.
Look at all the blood.
Come on, I need some target practice.
Who this guy?
Take it, cover.
Fuck up that asshole. Come to us.
Taking cover! I'll flush him out.
Oh, motherfuckers die first.
Slip behind him.
That shit's all him. Let's go.
Take him down.
Any last words, asshole?
Whoa, getting undercover. Little pissant. Whoa, getting undercover. Grenade's gonna blow! Grenade, move! Here we go!
Over there, shoot him for fuck's sake.
Firing on that piece of shit.
Let me move.
Yes.
Thought you were my friend, that you had me and Ellis's backs. It was just an act. You didn't kill me because I said no. You killed me because you thought you owned me, owned all of us.
It was never about us, about my old man, my father. I did anything for him, same as you and Sammy.
And you understand why I have to do this.
think you're alone in this world, Lincoln. But you're not. And you never will be.
Hell of a sight, ain't it? When I first come to this town, it was nothing more than a backwater shithole. Now look at it.
Let me see your hands.
Whatever was between us is over, you understand? It ended the second it was you coming up them stairs instead of my son. You want a drink?
All right.
I had this imported from Scotland. Single malt. Usually I'm a bourbon man, but I figured I'd order something with a little more class for when the casino opened. Not much of a chance of that happening now, is it?
Don't look that way.
Take a seat. I ain't going nowhere. Hey, not bad.
I think I still prefer shine.
You know, a month or so after my brother Lucho died, I started having nightmares. I had this one where I was on a boat. A giant wave come, knocked my ass overboard. I hit that water and sink like a goddamn rock. And there was another one where cotton mouths biting me all to hell. But the one that really got to me was Georgie's funeral. He's laid out in that shitty little casket. Neck cut, same as Lucho's. Yeah, that one really got to me. It'll come around again every 3 or 4 days.
That one where I'm back in Nam, sleeping in a foxhole. All of a sudden, these dark figures come out of the shadows. I try to fight them off, but they hold me down, tie my hands together, stuff a muddy rag in my mouth so I can't scream, can't warn the men sleeping next to me. And then I gotta listen as all those men die.
Imagine that's not gonna go away anytime soon.
No. I imagine it won't.
And then this. This was all to try to keep mine from coming true. Look how that turned out. I buried a lot of people. More than I can count. The one I never wanted to see go down in that cold ground was my son.
And yet here we are.
Yes, sir. Here we are. My son is dead. And I'm having a drink with his killer. I'm not gonna apologize for what I did, you understand? If I did, I'd just be lying. I don't have it in me to feel shame for the things I've done to others. Never have.
Didn't come here for an apology.
Nah. I know you didn't. Goddamn, I was right about you, wasn't I? I knew it the second I fucking saw you at the country club. Men like us, we're just wired up wrong. There's only one thing we know. One thing we're good at.
I'm gonna be waiting for you, Lincoln Clay. This won't be the last time we see each other.
I know.
What are you waiting for? Fucking do it. Finish.
Fuck you!
I take it you're Lincoln Clay.
So they tell me.
I told Sal this fucking casino would be the end of him. I meant it figuratively. This shit has a way of turning on you, doesn't it?
Especially if you piss off the wrong person.
You know who I am, son?
Guessing you're Leo Galante.
Take a little walk, you and me. Probably no surprise, but the rest of the commission wants you dead. You and anybody else that had anything to do with this.
What happened here was between me and Marcano.
I understand that, son. We all do. But this business makes you paranoid, irrational. They see Sally, a pile of shit. They start wondering if someone's gonna serve them a plate of their own.
So you're here to decide if you're coming after me?
No. I'm here to deliver a message. You made your point, son. This all ends right here, right now.
I got no quarrel with y'all.
Once a month, Sal kicked up 20% of his net. Cash only. Same man's been delivering it for, oh, I don't know, 20 years or so. I see no need in deviating from that, you?
No, sir.
In exchange, you run things as you see fit. Want to sell heroin? Want a whorehouse on every other corner? Makes no fucking difference to me. The only thing that matters is 20%.
What if I decide to walk away? Leave all this behind?
Then this will be the last time we see each other. Best of luck to you, son.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So, what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over. Done. Finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now, what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city, and it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
With Marcano dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's gonna shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't gonna be me, it's gonna be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
How you wanted to go to California, leave all this behind, and just start all over?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go. And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. Oh. I'll be seeing you, Padre.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear?
Father.
A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine is on the verge of breaking.
After Lincoln vanished, Vito Scaletta took over the city. I spit on Sal Marcano's grave one last time by actually doing what Marcano couldn't, finishing the casino. Now, 2 years later, Scaletta opened another casino, and then it was just an avalanche of development. Hotels, arenas, the new convention center. I mean, today everyone knows this place as the Las Vegas of the South, but the whole damn thing was built on bodies Lincoln Clay left behind with blood money he and his lieutenants stole from the mob. And Vito? He still lives in that penthouse at the top of Marcano's casino, looking out over the city he owns. After Sal Marcano's death, Lincoln Clay disappeared. The Bureau deprioritized the investigation after a few months, but I keep an active file. In 1971, I tracked him to a California shipyard where he was working under an assumed name. By the time we got there, though, he was gone. The trail went cold, and by 77, 78, I figured he was dead. But then I got a report of someone matching his description working with the Colombians. Since then, there's a new sighting of him every couple of years.
Lincoln made it out to California. Worked at the shipyards for a few years. Met him a woman. seemed like he was gonna get married, but then it all came apart. Don't know why. And he started moving around. He went to Alaska, New York, South America. He even went back to Vietnam. I still get postcards from time to time. You know, I think Lincoln wasn't able to accept the world for what it is, or his place in it.
Someday, he's going to get tired of running, or make a mistake, and I'll be waiting. I promise you that.
Let me ask you something. Senator! Where were you when John Fitzgerald Kennedy was assassinated?
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
Let me tell you where I was. A muddy hut in Vietnam. Slowly dismembering an old woman. Cutting her apart bit by bit. And do you know why? Because her son was an NVA officer. And hurting her was the only way to make him talk.
I don't understand what this has to do
with... What he told us saved the lives of an entire platoon. That's 42 men. Men that lived another day because I was willing to take a saw to that old woman.
Thank you, Mr. Donovan. I believe that...
Get out and shut the fuck up! I did a lot of terrible shit over there. In the name of this country. Shit that will haunt me for the rest of my life. But I did it because I believed in the fight. I believed what this nation stood for. So... to be sitting there ass deep in mud with that old woman scattered all around me and hearing that the President of the United States had just been fucking murdered? Well, I knew right then and there that I couldn't let that stand. That I would find a way to make it right no matter how long it took.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that Sal Marcano and a group of conspirators murdered Jack Kennedy.
Oh, that is the most absurd thing I have ever heard.
I assumed you would say that.
Don't fucking move! This... you're out of your mind.
Oh, I don't hold anyone's ambitions against them, Senator. And you certainly were ambitious, weren't you? You went to law school, and then you became a district attorney, and then... United States Senate. After Sal Marcano died, I went through his files. Imagine my surprise when I saw your name over and over and over and over again. The mob wanted Jack Kennedy dead, and you were more than willing to help.
But there are cameras everywhere. There's witnesses.
No, I want
you
them
never
to
get
see
away with
that, you stupid asshole, because then they will know that I am not finishing with you. I am starting with you.
Oh! Oh! Oh!